Yeah, this is a strange balance where you're describing a system that breeds consistency, and yeah, that's working exceptionally well. At the same time, if you get hit by a bus tomorrow, the Quibble Cop Empire does not function the same without
gone.
You.
It's gone. It's gone. Yeah, and the same thing, you're talking about being hit by a bus, you know, and being injured and maybe dying or being in the hospital, but it's even a lot. Like, a lot of people don't realize that even smaller things can influence somebody's YouTube channel. Let's say you just get sick, right? Uh-huh. For a week. Then for this entire week, either no videos or the videos are less quality. And that can spiral out of proportion. Let's say a traumatic event happens. One of your, you know, parents passes away. Or your girlfriend breaks up with you, right? Or, you know, some people even have smaller things. Let's say you get so much money that now all your friends are going to go crazy. And your friends aren't your real friends anymore. And they just see you as a money cow. Like, there are all these little things YouTubers have to deal with while still trying to be consistent with their YouTube videos. And all the viewers see is this YouTube video, while in the meantime, there are many, many YouTubers out there who are struggling with this stuff mentally, because it's like it's a very, very new and stressful and athletic business, as in you always got to perform.
Jake was talking about this. Jake from Vsauce 3 had a vlog on his personal channel where he detailed exactly what you just said. And he talked about, number one, he dealt with cancer a couple of years ago. That's a significant thing in terms of affecting your production and your health, you know, physical ability to perform and all of this. But he just had, in some ways, a hard year after that. And he detailed, like, this disrupted my creative process and my ability to churn out Vsauce 3 in a certain way. And so I had to pull back until all of that got sorted out. And then he went straight into Can You Survive the Movies and everything else. But it's a perfect example of him detailing exactly that disruption.
Jordy, do you think that a lot of the problem or the reason that it becomes so much more of a big deal for YouTubers is because of the consistency of needing to create, as opposed to other people in creative fields like an actor or a musician, who it seems like they can lay low for a little while if things are going wrong? They can turn down, if they can afford to, a movie role or, you know, take a while to make their next album or go on tour. But with you, if you're not uploading every single day, everyone's like, well, what happened to Quibble Cop?
Yeah, I feel like it's getting worse and worse over the years, right? So first you had actors and musicians. And with an actor, you can say, I'm going to do one good movie a year. And you're not going to be busy all year. You're going to be busy a few weeks. And then that movie could pay for the entire year. For your entire year, and sometimes even for your entire lifetime if you do well, right? And then you have musicians, and let's say we get a Drake or a Kanye West or a Kendrick Lamar, they might drop a new album every year, if you're lucky, right? And then now you're moving a step further, you go for DJs, right? So let's look at a Martin Garrix. Martin Garrix is, he's pumping out a new track every month. And then he also has to perform all the time. And while performing, he starts his show at midnight, like 11 or maybe midnight, and goes on to 5 a.m., right? So that the pressure is already really high. And then you look at a YouTuber and, you know, want to be a successful YouTuber, you got to do this stuff every day. No weekends for you, no holidays for you. And then the final step we have right now is being a streamer. Like, look at the biggest streamer in the world right now, Ninja. He's streaming 6 days a week, right? And he is on with these lights and performing. And one little slip up and, he gets put on blast. And it's not necessarily the fact that he's playing video games and he's looking at the camera, but he needs to keep in the back of his mind too. Like, okay, if I say something wrong, I'm going to, like, it's going to hurt me, right?
It could instantly ruin his career. I mean, it's going to be headline news everywhere. And gigantic backlash, boycott Ninja, blah, 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 blah. I mean, the implications and the pressure there couldn't be larger. It's kind of crazy.
And then 6 days a week, right? Like, no, you don't have any time
off. How many hours a day
off.
does he do on during those 6 days?
I think he streams like 10 hours a day, if not more. Yeah, it's crazy. It's insane. And you know, props to him for still being able to do that. But I'm already stressed out if I'm working a little bit too long, and then I can still take holidays, right? I can work ahead of schedule. Ninja takes holidays. People are like, Ninja's dead. I'm going to unsubscribe from his Twitch. He died of ligma. That was a joke a while back. And it seems to be getting worse and worse and worse. And it results in creator burnout. But then the platforms aren't really helping because they're literally built around consistency.
I was this, oh boy, this was June, July.